morning, Patriots. I'm Chelsea Duchesne.
And I'm Jacob Morgan. On Tuesday, the state ruled that the Kansas City School District will lose its accreditation on January 1st. The district students have the choice to leave the school district and join an accredited one. This means students from Kansas City may be piling into our school as early as this year.
Homecoming was a success this past weekend.
Jake Wingo has more on what leadership did to make your homecoming weekend a good one.
The homecoming dance and everything else that goes with it takes a lot more work than just decorating the cafeteria. It's a long process for the leadership committee that includes organizing the nominations for the court, the parade, class competitions, spirit week, the pep rally, the crownings, and eventually the dance.
We start planning homecoming back in the summer, and so we've been working on it for a really long time, getting everything ready for the volleyball games, the parade, the dance, the theme, the decorations. It all takes a lot of work, but leadership works really hard to get ready a couple weeks before so we can enjoy it and participate in all of the events.
While this seems like an overwhelming task to get all of that done and be able to execute each event, so much preparation has gone into it that they feel ready to take on the challenge.
Very prepared. We're at homecoming week and we're all ready to go. We're just finishing up final touches for decorations, and we have to send out the tickets for the Dig for a Difference game to the candidates tomorrow. We're getting all the parade finalizations, everybody lined up, so everything's going pretty good, and getting the program ready for the game.
There's no doubt that all of this can be hard work and can be stressful at times, but Adam Dively says it's also very exciting.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's challenging, but then seeing the big picture when it's all done, it makes it really worth it.
The dance itself, however, saw a drop in attendance last year, and most think that it was due to the new dance contract. Those who put up with the contract and attend anyways say that the dance is still just as much fun.
Well, I just dance around everybody else, and you know, to make sure they have fun, I just try to get them to dance just like me.
So enjoy the pep rally. Come out and support your Patriots as they take on St. Joe Central tonight. And then hit up the dance tomorrow with a name this year's homecoming king.
The softball team is swinging their way to the top.
Roy Bay has more on the story.
The Truman softball team has had an excellent past season at state, placing second. The team currently has a winning record, more fundamental drills, and infield warm-up. Head coach
Game's just a little different, and our preparation is a little different for every game based on our opponents, but we have a pretty consistent routine that we use in practice. We've started implementing a lot of new just fundamental drills over the course of the year, and a new infield warm-up, which incorporates a lot of different throws into our pre-game warm-up, but we do a lot of fundamentals. We do bunting almost every day. We do some kind of live hitting every day. We do mini warm-ups with all kinds of different ground balls every day, so it's pretty routine, and I think the kids have responded well to that.
The softball team is working hard to go from runner-up to state champion. The team has had to work hard to make up for the loss of some important senior players last year.
I think our goal is to probably go and make state again. I mean, that's one thing to come back from as last year, is to be a runner-up in state. I mean, we got to come back and we got to try that much harder. Paige is doing well. The girls are doing well. We got to keep it up.
As the softball team continues their quest to make state and hopefully break a couple records, I'm Roy Bay reporting for KTSN TV 15 News.
Dig for a Difference was a big success last Tuesday night. The senior boys yellow team walked away as winners of the tournament. In the end, we rallied in $536. Way to go, Patriots, and congratulations, seniors.
This year's swim team is off to a great start.
Brandon Travis was there to watch them swim for the gold.
1, 2!
This year's swim team is off to a good start. Every day, the boys are in the weight room lifting their way to the top.
Well, I mean, you need muscle to swim, so we just kind of get the overall fitness aspect of swimming, like we get all buff.
The boys' head swim coach explains how the team is preparing for the upcoming season.
Well, we're lifting a lot. We're lifting an hour before practice every day, and then we've been swimming about 7,000 or 8,000 yards every day during practice.
After a half hour of weightlifting, the team moves into the pool where the guys are improving their times as the days go by.
They are. I've seen definite improvement throughout the year. You know, it's a pretty quick improvement curve from you know, some guys came in not knowing anything really. They've learned all their strokes and they've improved to the point where they can compete in those races.
This year's swim team's a lot bigger than last year's team, and this is a very good thing.
We doubled our team from last year, and the new guys are doing pretty well. We still got to work on a couple of freshmen, but a couple of the newcomers are getting really good. We just need to work on a few technical things, and then we'll do real great.
The team this year is swimming their way through the water like a fish. I'm Brandon Travis reporting for KPSN TV 15 News.
There are many Patriots looking to make state this year.
Jacob Morgan has more on these state-bound Pats.
I'm injured right now, to hopefully come back in a week or two and then make it to state is the ultimate goal.
Goals are the driving force of many sports today. Softball is looking to complete these goals in this new 2011 season.
Everybody's personal goal is to hit a home run, so it's pretty much my personal goal. Or to just catch a ball over the fence is a pretty good goal, too.
Softball is 11-3 so far. They're looking to arrive at state for another year, for another winning season.
We're doing really good, and I think there's just more to come that we'll be doing fantastic. Down and get that batting average up, and pretty much just get a mental mindset of just doing good.
And I know I'm with everyone when I say good luck, Patriots. I'm Jacob Morgan with KTSN TV 15 News.
That's all we have for you today, Patriots.
Have a great week.